Hello everyone. We would like to present to you our fixed income outlook for the year 2020. But before we start, a quick recap on 2019. 2019 was a better year for bonds, with the benchmark G-Sec rallying by 75 basis points. In comparison, the bonds had a much flatter year in 2018. Much of the rally in 2019 was driven by soft inflation and weak growth outlook, leading to multiple rate cuts. Fiscal worries, however, started emerging from August as the economic slowdown and the corporate tax cuts were expected to widen fiscal deficit. These factors halted the rally, causing yields to reverse direction. So what do we expect in the year 2020? Let's start with fiscal deficit, which is a primary concern. Fiscal deficit, which emerged as a concern in 2019, is expected to remain so as we move into 20. Markets are currently factoring in a 0.3 to 0.5% slippage, and any deviation over this is likely to negatively impact yields. Markets will also keenly await the 2021 estimates on fiscal deficit to evaluate the deviation from the fiscal glide path. How have credit market conditions behaved? One of the factors that impeded rate transmission for most part of 2019 was a tight credit market. Credit spreads remain highly elevated even 12 to 15 months after the crisis, leading to a degrowth for most of the NBFCs. However, we expect that the RBI and the government will remain focused to alleviate and to defreeze the credit market in 2020. As far as growth is concerned, after peaking at about 8.2% in the June quarter of 2018, GDP has seen a sustained fall to touch a low of 4.5% in September 2019. However, growth could probably have bottomed out at these levels, as is already being reflected in the high frequency data, which is showing some improvement. Auto sales and other consumer spending data in the festive season have also shown an uptick. Further, agri, which had a weak Q2, should benefit from a good monsoon going forward. Overall, Q3 and Q4 GDP prints should range between 5.3 to 5.5%. As far as rates are concerned, RBI cut rates 5 times in 2019, aggregating 135 basis points, but finally paused at the December policy. We expect RBI to probably cut rates once more, although the timing remains in question. Rates at the longer end of the curve are, however, likely to witness some upward pressure from fiscal challenges and rising bond supply in 2020. This could be moderated to some extent if RBI intervenes and decides to buy long-term bonds in exchange for shorter tenor securities. On liquidity, we remain extremely positive. Given that the rate transmission is still incomplete, RBI is expected to keep liquidity in the positive zone. Further, dollar inflows also helped vastly in the year 2019, helping local liquidity. Combined debt and equity flows in 19 stood at a positive $12.5 billion as against a negative $11 billion in 2018. Global factors also played a major role in 2019 and are expected to continue as we move into 20 as well. For instance, the Fed cut rates thrice in 2019 after having hiked rates 4 times in 2018. Both the ECB and Japan currently have negative interest rates and continue with their accommodative stance and QE. Given all of this and this background, it is appropriate for fixed income investors to position themselves at the shorter end of the curve. With the majority of the rate cycle now behind us, the risk reward is also not very favorable for duration. Investors with a very short-term horizon up to 3 months can consider the ultra-short-term category. Conservative investors with a 12-month and longer horizon can consider short-term products such as the banking and PSU fund or the corporate bond fund for more steady returns. Thank you, and wishing you all a very happy and prosperous year 2020. And happy investing.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.